Good morning, students. The topic for today is the first chapter, Theoretical Approaches in Medical Sociology. Okay, in this chapter we are going to see a few models. The first one is the medical model of disease. I've sent a video on medical model as well as social model of disease. In the medical model, it says that the body is like a machine. Okay, and all the parts of the body are like parts of the machine, and the equilibrium or the way in which it functions should be effective and efficient. When there is a problem in any part, then the person gets a disease. This medical model explains things like diseases like malaria, pneumonia, tuberculosis, cancer and other diseases. So whenever a part of the body does not function properly, then it is called as disease, and this is the medical model of disease. The next one is the psychological theory of disease. This theory is about an appraisal or the contribution of psychiatrists and psychologists, and Sigmund Freud was one of the first person who told about this theory. And this theory states that mental diseases and their causes. So every human being has drives or a need to do certain things, and when these things are correct, it is normal life. When these mental aspects which make you do certain things are wrong, then it is called as mental illness. This is the psychological theory of disease. Then we come to the culture bound theory of disease. So this theory tells that every culture can cause disease, and some examples are in Tamil Nadu we have a phenomena called soodu pidichiruchu nu vaanga, adavadhu when the heat because of the summer you get pain in your stomach, and when you urinate also you have pain. This is a disease that is caused because of dehydration, because of less water in your human in the body. But what the culture says is that it is caused because of some problem which is not because of dehydration but because of some other issue, and so they put castor oil on the stomach and they give some other medications which do not help. Actually, if you drink water, the sudo will go off. So this is culture bound theory of disease. Next we come to the socio environmental theory of disease. Here the fact is society determines how much a person earns, what education the person will study, what occupation the person does. So all this is determined by the society. So how much you earn is based on what you study, and what you study is based on your parents' occupation, and all the other factors. So they are all interrelated, and these can cause disease and good health. So if a person works in the field, he may get snake bite, he may get sunburn and such diseases. If a person works in an industry, he may get industrial diseases. So this is the socio-environmental theory of disease, based on the society, based on your job, based on the environment, what disease you get. So these are some of the theories of disease and illness. So in conclusion, we can say that there is no disease or illness that cannot be explained by any of these theories in medical sociology. Every disease has a reason. If a mental disorder has a mental cause for it, or problem in the mind, a physical problem or physical disease is caused by malfunction of the human anatomy or the body, or other diseases are caused by social, economic, environmental and cultural factors. So every disease can be explained in medical sociology through these theories. Okay, so other than these theories, there are some important approaches which sociologists have done. They are social structural approach, which is a which considers society to be an objective reality. The next we will come to other approaches. Then the social structure approach. The other approach is called as the symbolic interactional approach, and there the sociologists consider the society as subjective realities. So under objective realities there are two theories. One is called structural functionalism and the other is called Marxism. So the words may seem a little difficult for you, but they are very simple. I'll try to explain it in simple terms. So these are the other theories, other than the models of health that we saw already. These are theories of health and illness. So the first one is structural functionalism, second one is Marxism. So in this, what we see is functionalism. Function means what we do. So this theory talks about how health is caused by what work we do and what we do in the society. A simple example, for example, poverty means not able to earn money. So the functionalist theory tells poverty is caused because of social stratification. That is, in society people are divided into high class, low class, and that is because of the job they do and the income that they earn. And that is why poverty is caused if a person earns very less and they do not have enough money because of their lifestyle. And they may also have less knowledge, less skill, and that is why they are poor. So simply speaking, a person in the society will be poor because they do not have enough knowledge and skills to do a industrial work or a high quality white collar job. So such people are having poverty. On the other hand, the Marxist explanation, Marxism, what they say is poverty is caused because of the class structure. So within the society there are people who work and the people who make money out of the workers. They are called the exploiters. And the people who work are the people who are exploited. So the poor people who work, all the money goes to the rich people. So this causes poverty in the poor people because they do all the work but the money goes to the rich people in a capitalist society. So this is called Marxism, and that is a Marxist explanation of poverty. So next we will see in health how this functionalism theory works. So we will see this Parsonsian functionalism and the sick role. So Talcott Parsons is a very important sociologist. In 1951 he told this theory. This theory is the functionalist perspective of health and illness. Okay, remember carefully, functionalist perspective of health and illness. So what does this functionalist perspective tell? It says good health and good medical care are necessary for society to function. So if a society has to function normally, good health of all the people is very important, and medical care is also very important. So if a person does not have good health, or if the person is sick or unhealthy, then society and the functioning of the society will suffer. The stability of the society will also suffer. So as far as everybody is healthy, the society will function normally. So if there is any ill health, then the society will be affected. One good example is the current situation of coronavirus. You know, because of the ill health, the whole society is suffering. So because of poor health, because of less effective medical care, we do not have enough ventilators, we do not have enough ICUs in our country, and because of that the whole society is suffering because everybody is told to stay inside the house. This is called functionalist perspective of health and illness. Okay, So when the person becomes sick and when the person dies early, what happens is their regular social roles cannot be carried out. So in the society there are various costs, and poor medical care also makes the society dysfunctional. Again, I am saying this is very clearly seen in the example of coronavirus. Because we do not have adequate health care, the society is dysfunctional. It is not functioning at all. We are all sitting inside the home and our normal life is affected. So this is what Talcott Parsons told at that time. Okay. And he also defined health and against illness is defined as the state of optimum capacity of an individual for the effective performance of the roles and tasks for which he or she has been socialized. So he said health means the optimum capacity of an individual, the best way in which you can work, and the effective performance and roles and tasks. So if you are able to do 100% of your role in the society and all the job that is required of you in the society, then you are having good health. If you are not able to function to 100%, then you are having poor health. So this is what functionalist perspective tells. Okay, so another important thing based on the functionalist perspective is the sick role. What is the sick role? Okay, this is an important question which you get in every question paper. So remember, listen carefully. When a person becomes sick, the society cannot function smoothly. When a person is healthy, the society can function smoothly. ஒருத்தர் நல்ல ஹெல்த்தோடு இருந்தாங்கன்னா சொசைட்டி நல்லா ஃபங்க்ஷன் ஆகும். வென் த பர்சன் இஸ் சிக், த சொசைட்டி டஸ் நாட் ஃபங்க்ஷன் ப்ராப்பர்லி. ஸோ இஃப் யூ பிகம் சிக், யூ வில் நாட் பி ஏபிள் டு டூ வாட் யூ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டூ இன் த சொசைட்டி. திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அன்மோட்டிவேட்டட் டீவியன்ஸ். ஸோ எனி இல்னஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் இஸ் அன்மோட்டிவேட்டட் டீவியன்ஸ். டீவியன்ஸ் மீன்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் வாட் யூ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டூ யூ ஆர் டீவியேட்டிங். மோட்டிவேட்டட் மீன்ஸ் யூ ஆர் டூயிங் இட் பர்பஸ்ஃபுல்லி. Because sickness comes without your role in it, it's called unmotivated deviance. Okay, the regulation of this sickness comes through the mechanism of sick role. So doctors are the people who control the sickness. So if a person gets sick, you go to the doctor. So the doctor will examine you, he will diagnose the disease and he will give treatment. So this is the process in which a sick person becomes healthy. First he may be sick, he goes to the doctor diagnoses the disease, he treats the disease, the patient takes the treatment, and then the patient becomes better. So this is the normal steps in which a sick person becomes a normal or healthy person. So Talcott Parsons had few expectations of the sick person. So these are the things which any sick person will undergo. The first thing is, the sick person should not be perceived as having caused their own health problem. So we should never say a person who is smoking, because he gets lung cancer, he is the cause of the disease. We should never say a person who eats high fat food and gets cholesterol, if he gets a heart attack, we should never say that he is the reason for getting the disease. Okay, so this is something that is very important. He said sick people should not be thought of having caused their own health problem. It is not like that. There may be 100 people who smoke, out of which only 5 people will get lung cancer. So we should have the same sympathy to these 5 people as we have to other people. Okay, that is the first thing. The second thing is, sick people must want to get well. You know, there may be some people in this world who always tell, I am sick, and they do not do their regular jobs. Okay, so we should not be like such people, and sick people must want to get well. And if some people are not wanting to get well, or even if some people are acting as if they are sick, then they are not considered as sick people by the society because they are not really sick. Then the third thing he said is, people are expected to have their illness confirmed by a physician or a doctor or even other healthcare professionals and to follow their instructions to become well. If a sick person does not follow the instructions, then they cannot perform the sick role. So even now in coronavirus, people are told to stay inside their house. People are told to wash their hands. People are told to wear masks. But we see in our society that there are a lot of people who are not following the instructions of the healthcare professional and they may become sick. So then they lose the right to perform the sick role. Okay, so if all the above expectations are met, then sick people are treated by the family, friends and other people, and their normal responsibilities in their society, they can be relieved. So for example, a person who is sick, if really he is sick, if he is not acting that he is sick, and if he is diagnosed by a doctor as a sick person, and the sick person takes proper treatment, and such a person can be considered to be undergoing the sick role. And such people who are sick will be allowed not to do their regular society. Okay, this is simple. So for example, if I tell an example for the sick role, a person who is having a heart attack. So the person is taken to the hospital and the person is really having pain in the chest. He is not acting as if he is having pain. Then the doctor diagnoses the disease and then the doctor tells rest and adequate diet and other, he gives treatment, then the patient should take those treatments. If all that is done by the patient, then he is considered to be undergoing sick role and then he can be given rest from the responsibilities that he has to play in the society. Okay, so that is the patient's sick role. So what is the doctor's role in this? The doctor's role is they have to diagnose the disease. They also should decide how to treat the disease and finally make the person to become well. So in this, the doctor will diagnose the disease and will provide the treatment, but the patient also has to take the treatment. He has to follow the instructions of the doctor. So this is the patient-physician relationship. Okay, so a patient has to follow the instructions of the doctor. The doctor has to diagnose and treat the disease. If both the people, if the patient and the physician follow their roles correctly, then the patient will become well. He will not have disease and he will have good health. So there is a little more about the concept of sick role. The concept of sick role says that there are some aspects of the sick role. What are they? The sick person has an exemption. That means he can avoid doing his normal role and responsibilities because of his sickness. And the more severe the sickness, the greater the exemption. For example, if you have a small pain in your neck, then you can come to work every day. But at the same time, if you have severe chest pain and you have a heart attack, then you are given 100% complete rest for at least 1 month. So that is the difference. Severe illness means more exemption from the regular role you have to play. The next thing is, sick person is not responsible for his condition or her condition. Sickness is considered beyond the control of the person. Whatever the sickness, even if the person drinks and gets liver problem, as per the sick role, the person is not responsible for getting the liver problem because of drinking. Okay, because it is beyond his control. The next point is, the sick person should try to get well. Being sick is an undesirable condition. So sick person should have always in their heart, they should want to get well. They should not think that I will be like this, lying on the bed for 1 month, 2 months. Instead, they should actively participate in the treatment and try to get well. The next thing is the sick person should seek medical advice and cooperate with the medical experts. So if a person is sick, they have to go to the doctor, and then they are, after the disease is diagnosed, they have to take proper treatment as per the doctor's advice. Okay, then we come to the next part, which is the rights and responsibilities of people who are sick. Every person who becomes sick has some rights and responsibilities. That is, their right is their exemption from normal responsibilities. So if a person is sick, they can avoid their regular work, whether it is their industrial work or if it is their household work. Whatever it is, they can avoid that work because of their sickness. But the responsibility of the sick person is he should want to recover, he should seek medical advice, and he should follow the medical advice, and then only the person will get well. So these are the rights and responsibilities of the sick person. So, but there are some criticisms of the sick role. What are the criticisms of sick role? Parsons was surely right in telling that individual's good health will help the society. If a person is healthy, then the society will also function normally. But his theory has been criticized because most of his ideas of the sick role applies to short-term conditions like heart attack or acute conditions or sudden severe conditions, heart attack or coronavirus or cold and fever. These are all diseases which come suddenly, they stay for a short time, the person recovers or dies, you know. But there are a lot of chronic diseases, long-term diseases. For example, a person may have asthma. Asthma is not a disease which comes in one day and goes in 5 days. It is there for most people for life. Same way arthritis. It is a disease which occurs and then it stays with the person for life. Same way psoriasis. These are all chronic illnesses. So Parsons' sick role and other theories do not apply to chronic diseases. It applies mainly to the short-term diseases or acute diseases. And also, Parsons' theory gives a lot of emphasis on the doctor-patient relationship, and it tells the doctor is the person who is actively involved in treating the person, and it takes away the responsibility from the patient. Actually, patient is also responsible for getting well. Suppose a patient does not follow the advice, then he will not be having the sick role. So all these things are criticizing the role of sick role. So the emphasis on diagnosing the disease is on the doctor as per Parsons. So these are all reasons for criticizing the sick role, which is a theory by Parsons. So society functions because of the healthy individuals who are part of the society. Okay, if there is illness or poor health, it leads to illness behavior or sick role of the individual. This prevents the person from playing his normal role. And when a person does not play his normal role, then the society is also affected. So this is the basic understanding of Parsons' theory of health. Okay, so there is one question which is common, other than the sick role and other this theory. There is one more question which says, society is a sum of its parts, explain. So the answer for that is, society is like a organism or a biological organism or the like a human body, for example. So it is made up of interconnected and integrated parts. So every part of the society, who form the part of the society? First the individuals, then individuals form families, families form communities, and communities form the society. So every aspect of the society should function normally because they are interconnected. So individuals should be normal, they should be healthy, and then only the families will be healthy, and then only communities will be healthy. If any person or any family or any community is sick, then the society will not function normally and the whole society will suffer. Just like if your heart is not functioning properly, it is not just the heart which is suffering, it is your whole body which is suffering. Similarly, all parts of the society should do their role, and if they do not do their role, it will cause problem like social problems and social disorganization, which will lead to a dysfunctional society. So society is a sum of its parts. So it is an addition of all the parts of the society. You cannot say one part is not needed, only the other parts are needed. Every part of the society is needed, and together it forms a normal, well-functioned society. If any part of this society is not functioning properly, then it will lead to dysfunctional society because of social problems and social disorganization. So that is why society is called as a sum of its parts. It is an addition of everything in the society. It is a combination of the individuals, families and communities that form the society. Hope you understood this class. Next class we'll see one more theory, and we'll also see what is medical gaze. Thank you.